Hello students, welcome to AIIMS India online classes. This is a chemistry session. Here we are discussing about the chapter periodic classification. In this session we are going to see about modern periodic table. In the earlier class we have seen about earlier attempts for the classification of elements which were done by different scientists, and we have seen some defects or drawbacks in those classifications also. And now in this session we are going to see about modern periodic classification, which was done by Moseley, even which we are following even now too. Okay, let us see about this. After the discovery of atomic number, the periodic law was modified and the new law was proposed by the British chemist Henry Moseley in 1914. Okay, in the earlier periodic law was given based upon the atomic masses of the elements. What was that? The chemical and physical properties of the elements are periodic functions of their atomic masses. Means till the Mendeleev, the earlier scientists all, they have tried to classify the elements based upon their atomic masses. They have taken the atomic mass as a standard quantity for classifying the elements into different batches. What he done, Mendeleev, he written all the available elements at that time in the increasing order of their atomic masses. And then the elements with the similar properties kept in one column called groups. But by taking this atomic mass as a basic quantity, there they have faced some drawbacks in the classification or some limitations in the classification of elements. But when it was found atomic number, Moseley identified that this atomic number can be the accurate quantity for classification of elements. The law is based upon the atomic numbers in place of atomic masses of the elements. After the change in the periodic law, many changes were suggested in the periodic table. Yes, as the atomic number has been taken as a standard quantity for a classification, then many changes were done in the earlier periodic table. When the elements are arranged in the increasing order of their atomic numbers instead of atomic masses, most of the defects of Mendeleev's classification get rectified. Yes, there were some defects in the Mendeleev's classification as he has arranged the elements in the order of their atomic masses. For example, if you see the placement of hydrogen, he was in confusion to place the hydrogen in two different groups. One it is in the first group along with the other metals. One more in the seventh group along with some other non-metals like halogens. Okay, so because it is showing the properties of these two and atomic number was not the basis. So when it is the atomic number is taken as a basis for classification, along with the atomic number, they considered electronic configuration of these elements also. By taking these two into consideration, hydrogen will get only one place instead of two. In that way, the defect in the Mendeleev's classification is rectified. Not only that, the placement of isotopes of an element, which was one of the defects in the Mendeleev's classification, isn't it? What was that? If we take element carbon, isn't it? If you see for element carbon, there are three isotopes. According to the mass numbers basis, they should be provided three places for carbon separately, because mass numbers are being different for three isotopes. But Mendeleev could give only one place for carbon in his periodic table. That we told as one of the defects, placement of isotopes. But when we take atomic number as a basis instead of atomic mass, so these all isotopes will be having same atomic number. Even though their mass numbers are different, they will be having same atomic number. So there is no confusion in providing number of places. Only one place for carbon, even though it has three isotopes. In that way, that defect also rectified by taking atomic number as a basis instead of atomic mass for the classification. Okay. Next, modern periodic law. How it is changed, let us see here. Earlier, the Mendeleev's periodic law was the chemical and physical properties of the elements are periodic functions of their atomic masses. Now, in the place of atomic mass, atomic number has been taken. Now, the modern periodic table can be stated as the chemical and physical properties of the elements are periodic functions of their atomic numbers. Means, when elements are written in the increasing order of their atomic numbers, the physical and chemical properties are being repeated or resembling with one element to another element. Those all elements which are getting the similar chemical properties kept in one column and they are called group. Okay, in that way it is changed, modified. The modern periodic table is constructed based upon this law, that is based upon the atomic numbers. Not only atomic numbers, the electronic configuration is also taken into consideration. So, cause for the periodicity. So, why this periodicity is occurring when elements are written in the increasing order of their atomic numbers? That is, the repetition of the similar outer shell electronic configuration at certain irregular intervals. Yes, the main cause for the repetition, the main cause for the periodicity of the properties is similar electronic configurations of certain elements. For example, let us see the first group or first column elements in this periodic table, like lithium, sodium, potassium, hydrogen. These all elements present in the same column. If it is observed, their electronic configurations, if we observe for hydrogen, the electronic configuration is 1s1, isn't it? If you see some other element, the next element, lithium, for it, the electronic configuration is being 1s2, 2s1. If you see some other element in the same column, sodium, for it, the configuration is being 1s2, 2s2, it is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. If you observe, for this all, one thing is being common, that is valence shell electronic configuration. So, the elements which are getting the similar valence electronic configuration exhibiting similar chemical properties, similar properties. So, in this way, it was identified in the modern periodic table by Moseley. When he written the elements in the increasing order of their atomic numbers, some elements, they are getting similarity in the chemical properties. So, he wrote those all elements in the one column. And even he observed those elements are getting same valence electronic configuration. This is the reason for their chemical similarity. Okay. Now, it is modern periodic table. This is called Moseley's periodic table. Even it is also called long form periodic table. If you observe totally, there are 18 columns. There are 18 vertical columns. And there are 7 horizontal rows. So, each column, suppose if you see this first column, this column is called one group. So, each vertical column is considered as a group. Vertical columns are considered as groups. And again, these horizontal rows are called periods. So, in that way, you can say there are 18 vertical columns and 7 horizontal rows. These total 18 vertical columns are considered divided into mainly 8 groups. 1 to 8 groups. And again, each group is subclassified into two subgroups, A and B. Suppose if I say now, first group, it contains two subgroups. So, this is a 1A, first A subgroup. First A group it is called. In one more it is there, at the middle 11th column in the modern periodic table, that is also first group only. But it is subgroup B. So, 1A, 1B. In the same way, this is 2A, this is 2B, third A, third B. In this way, totally 18 vertical columns are divided into 8 groups. Each group again subdivided into 2 subgroups A and B. Now you can say there are 16 groups. 8 groups, also correct? 16 groups because of the subgroups in each group again. Why 18 columns are divided into 16 groups means, if you observe here, these three columns, 8th, 9th, 10th, columns are considered as one group, that is 8th B group. So these three columns are considered as 8th B or 8th group. Okay, this is 8th A, this is 8th B. That is totally 16 groups only. And each horizontal row is considered as one period. So this contains totally 7 periods. If you observe the first period, there are 2 elements, hydrogen and helium. This is second period, there are 8 elements. Third period also, there are 8 elements. And if you see fourth and fifth periods, there are totally 18 elements in each. And if you see sixth period, in this play here, there are 16 places, 18 places, and 14 more elements kept down. Actually, these all elements, this row elements also should be in this place. Now total it becomes 32 elements in the sixth period. So we can say this is one of the longest periods. Okay, to make it convenient in writing, these 14 elements are kept down separately from the sixth period. And even in the same way, in the seventh period also, here in this place, these all elements should be placed. To make it convenient, these elements are written down separately. Now we can say the 6th and 7th periods are longest periods because they contain each 32, but 14 elements are written down. Okay, this is about a modern periodic table. Okay, let us see some features of this now. Main features of this periodic table, among them one is, in the long form of periodic table, there are 18 vertical columns. 18 vertical columns which are called as groups, and there are 7 horizontal rows which are called as periods. Okay, 18 vertical columns are classified into 8 main groups and each against 2 subgroups, totally 16 groups, and each horizontal row is considered as one period. Next, elements present in the group 1 and group 2 on the left side and the group 13 to 17 on the right side of the periodic table are called normal elements or representative elements. Okay, these 7 groups. What are those? First, left side 2 groups, 1A and 1B, and right side, except the last but last group, remaining 5 groups, they are 3A, 3B to 7A. 3A to 7A. These 5 columns or 5 groups, these all together considered as normal elements or representative elements. Because these elements which are existing naturally exist in the compounds for more reactive chemicals responsible with most of the chemical reactions. That's why they are called normal elements or representative elements. In periods, elements are arranged in the increasing order of their atomic numbers. Yes, in this periodic table, in each period, if we observe, elements are in the increasing order of their atomic numbers. Next, the first period is the shortest period of all the periods because it contains only 2 elements, namely hydrogen and helium. Isn't it? We have seen the first period of the modern periodic table contains only 2 elements, hydrogen and helium. So it is called shortest period of the modern periodic table. Next, the second and third periods, as we told, they contain 8 elements in each. So these two periods, second and third, are called short periods because they contain only 8 elements in each. Next, fourth and fifth periods contain 18 elements in each. So they are called long periods. Next, sixth and seventh periods, as we have discussed in the diagram, there are 32 elements in each period. That is, 18 elements are there in that period and 14 elements are kept separate and written down at the bottom of the periodic table. So totally 18 plus 14, 32 elements are there in each 7th and 6th period. So these two periods are called longest periods or very long periods in the modern periodic table. So short period is the first, second and third are very short period is first period, second and third are short periods, fourth and fifth are long periods, and 6th and 7th periods are very long periods or longest periods. Okay, earlier it might have heard the 7th period is incomplete period, only the longest period is 6th period. But now, in the recently, they have discovered some elements which were kept as blanks in the modern periodic table. Now, the modern periodic table is completely filled with these 118 elements. So, 7th period also contains 32 elements now. So, we say 6th and 7th periods are longest periods. Okay? Now, let us see the special names given for the groups and periods in the modern periodic table. That is, based upon the properties of those elements or based upon the sources from where these elements are existing, based upon their characteristics, certain common names or special names are given for these groups of elements. Now, let us see these here. First among them, first column elements which are called alkali metals. You see the periodic table, these are first column elements. There are 7 elements, namely, there are 8 elements actually. How many are there? 7. Yes, 7 elements. 7 periods, 7 elements. Hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium. So, out of these 7 elements, except that first element, except that hydrogen, the 6 elements present in the first column or 1A group of the periodic table are named as alkali metals. These are, what are those alkali metals? Lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium and francium. These elements are called alkali metals because they form alkalis. What is meant by alkali? We know the bases which are soluble into water are called alkalis. So, these first column elements except hydrogen, they form bases which are soluble into water. Hence, these elements are called alkali metals. Based upon that property, these are named as alkali metals. Alkali metals are very reactive. Yes, these alkali metals are very reactive. That is why they do not occur freely in the nature. As they are highly reactive metals, always they are available to us in the form of their compounds. For example, if you say sodium, freely sodium does not exist in the nature. It always exists in the compounds form. Mostly sodium is available for us in the form of sodium chloride, common salt, isn't it? Not only that, some other compounds also like sodium carbonate, sodium oxide. In this way, so these alkali metals, they do not occur in the nature free. As their high reactivity, they are always available in the combined state only. Alkali metals are soft and good conductors of heat and electricity. Yes, even though these are metals, these are existing in the soft solid form. Even they can be cut with a knife also, like our soap. That much soft these are metals. And even they are good conductors of heat and electricity. Remaining properties are same, but these are, instead of being hard, they are soft metals and highly reactive. Okay, that's about first group elements. They are called alkali metals. Remember, except hydrogen, because hydrogen is not a metal. We know as it is a non-metal. Except that, remaining all are metals which are called alkali metals. Right? Next, let us see one more. Alkaline earth metals. That is, the second column elements. If you see, these are 6. What are those? Beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium and radium. These 6 elements present in the second column or second A group of the periodic table are named as alkaline earth metals. Because the oxides and hydroxide formed by these metals are strongly alkaline. So, these metals also, they form bases which are soluble into water. So, these bases are all called alkalis. Second A group elements also, they form alkalis. And one more point is here, these metals are mostly available from the earth crust. These metal components exist in the earth crust. So, based upon these two points, these metals are called as alkaline earth metals. Okay, second A group elements are called alkaline earth metals. Alkaline earth metals are very reactive metals that do not occur freely in the nature and widely distributed in the rock structure. Even these alkaline earth metals are also highly reactive, just like the alkali metals, and hence they do not occur freely in the nature. These also exist in the form of their compounds, just like the rocky material. So they exist in the earth crust. Next group, noble gases, the last column elements. If you see the extreme right side column of the modern periodic table, these elements, what are those here? Helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, and radon. These elements which are located in the extreme right side of the modern periodic table, that is group 18 of the periodic table, are named as noble gases because they were thought to be completely inert, unable to form compounds. They do not participate in the chemical reactions. They do not participate in the chemical reactions with themselves, even with the other elements also. That is why they are called noble gases. Noble gases are very unreactive and exist as atomic gases. Yes, as we told, these elements, they do not participate in the chemical reaction with any other chemical substances, and even they won't combine themselves also. That is why they exist always in the atomic gaseous form. That's why they are called noble gases, and also they are called inert gases. And even they exist in the atmosphere in the rare quantity. That's why they are called rare gases also. And even if you observe, all these elements in this 8A group are gases. These all are called gases. That is why they are also called specially aerogens. Okay, these are the special names of these 8A group elements: noble gases, ideal gases, rare gases, aerogens. So these are the special names for these column elements. Zero group elements also they are called. Okay, next, halogens. This 17th column or 7A group elements. What are those? Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, astatine. These elements of 7A group or 17th group are commonly called halogens. Actually, the meaning of halogens, this name halogens, is derived from the meaning, that is salt formers. The meaning of these halogens word is salt formers, because most of the metal salts are formed in the form of fluorides, chlorides, bromides. Most of the salts are available in the form of the fluorides, chlorides, bromides, or iodides. Based upon this reason, these group 7A group elements are called as halogens, meaning salt formers. Okay, because of their great reactivity, the free halogen elements are not found in the nature. Yes, these non-metals are also, just like the remaining alkali metals and alkali earth metals, how did you told? These 7th group elements are also highly reactive. These are also highly reactive. That's why these also will not exist in the free, in the nature, in the free form. These also exist in the compounds form only. For example, we can say chlorine. Chlorine is one of the highly reactive non-metal. That is why it won't exist in the nature in the free form. Mostly exist in the compounds form, just like sodium chloride, common salt. Mostly exist in the seawater, isn't it? So this common salt contains sodium and chlorine. Here chlorine is being more reactive. It exists in the compound form. It won't exist in the free state for us. Right? The halogen group is the only periodic table group that contains elements in the three forms of the main states of the matter at a standard temperature and pressure. Yes, interesting. It is one of the interesting points in the periodic table. We can see this is the only group in the modern periodic table which contains the elements in the three main groups of the matter, three main states of the matter. If you observe the first two elements, fluorine and chlorine, these two elements are gaseous elements. Fluorine is a gaseous element. Even chlorine is also one of the gaseous element. These two are gaseous non-metals. If you see bromine, bromine is a liquid element. Even to say it is the only liquid non-metal. Isn't it? Reddish brown liquid non-metallic element is bromine. If you see the remaining two elements, iodine and astatine, these two are solid elements, solid non-metals. So in this way, in this group, the elements are existing in the three states of matter. No other group in this periodic table contains in this way three states of elements. If you say the extreme right side group, only gaseous elements are there. If you see, mostly all solids are there. Of course, this is gaseous element, remaining all are solids. Somewhere at the middle, one more liquid element is there. But here, this group contains completely three states of elements. Solids, liquids and gas are existing in this. This specialty of this group, we can say. Okay, this is about halogens. 7th A group elements are called halogens. Still, there are some more groups. Let us discuss about them in our next session. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our YouTube channel AIIMS Today for latest updates and recorded videos.